All right, so let's continue with chapter 7, part 2. Now let's go into the combining forms of these. So we want to look at calic, cali, cyst, glomerule, mie. Okay, so cali is cup shape. So caliectasis would be dilation of the calyx, or calicele would be pertaining to a calyx. Cyst is urinary bladder, so cystitis would be inflammation of the urinary bladder. Glomerule, so glomerular is pertaining to the glomerulus. Meatus, so let's say you can get a meatal stenosis or meatotomy, incision of a meatus. So neph, pile, ren, tri, so neph meaning kidney, so that would be, let's say nephrotosis, prolapse of the kidney, nephropexy, fixation of the kidney, nephrolithotomy, incision to remove a kidney stone, nephrosclerosis, hardening of the kidney. So you can see there's a lot there. Pyelo, renal pelvis, so pyelolithotomy, okay, that would be incision of the renal pelvis to remove a stone. Pyelogram would be a record, such as a radiograph or an x-ray of the renal pelvis. Rene would mean kidney, so you can call it renal ischemia, holding back of blood flow to the kidney. Renal transplantation, placement of a kidney from one person into another. Renal calculus, that's a kidney stone. Renal dialysis, which is complete separation of waste materials, urea, creatinine, uric acid from the blood using a kidney machine or fluid in the peritoneum. Okay. And then trigone would be trigonitis, which would be inflammation of the trigone, which is the area in the bladder. And then you have a ureter, urethra, and vess. So ureterocele, ureterocele, hernia of the ureter, uretolithotomy, incision of ureter to remove a stone, ureteroileostomy, which is would be a new opening between the ureter and the ileum. Now urethra would be urethritis, that would be inflammation of the urethra, urethroplasty, surgical repair of the urethra, and then vesc is another urinary bladder, so perivesical, pertaining to surrounding the bladder. So those are combining forms. Here's some more combining forms. Albumin. Okay, so albuminuria, protein in the urine. Azotemia, nitrogen in the blood. Bacteriuria, bacteria in the urine. So anything with urea would be something in the urine. Okay. Dips, polydipsia, which is a condition of increased thirsty. So next time you're like, oh, I'm sure thirsty, you can say, well, I'm experiencing polydipsia. Albumin, azot, bacterio, dips, thirst. Cal means what? Ketone bodies. Okay. Natro, nocto, oligo. So cal means potassium. Okay. Keto is ketosis, right? You've heard of that. Litho. Natro, nocto, so nocturia, excessive urination at night, so people that bed the wet the bed, and the oligo is scanty, so oliguria would be scanty urination. Poitin, pi, trypsi, urea, and ure. So poitin would be substance that forms. Pious pus, so it'd be pyurea, would be pus in the urine. Okay, trypsy. Okay, urea, like uremia or uremia. Urea, urination. Okay. Dysuria would be difficult or painful urination. Urine. Okay, so these are just combining forms or suffixes that you could add. What's the test of urinalysis? Yeah, well, that can include color, appearance, the pH, protein, glucose. So normal pH of a urine is slightly acidic. Yeah, 6.5. They like to keep it around there. Protein test looks for albumin, which could indicate a leak in the glomerular membrane. Glucose present could signal possibility of diabetes. We talked about the color, right? If it's clear, you might have a large amount of water. If it's red, maybe blood in the urine. Specific gravity reflects all the waste and minerals. Ketone bodies appear when the body starts to break down fat. Sediment, those are usually abnormal particles that we don't like. Phenylketonuria indicates a lack of enzyme, found usually in infants, and then bilirubin results for a hemoglobin breakdown. So those are all the things that you can look for to see what could be going wrong inside. In a urinalysis, what does the test of specific gravity reflect? That would be D, the amount of waste, minerals, and solids in the urine. All right, so let's look at some pathological conditions that you might come up with. So glomerulonephritis. Glomerulonephritis. Okay. Interstitial nephritis. Nephrolithiasis. And nephrotic syndrome. Kidney disease, you can get polycystic kidney disease, PKD. The kidneys contain masses of cysts. Typically, polycystic kidneys weigh 20 times more than the usual weight. And usually, they're hereditary condition. Again, you can get pyelonephritis, is inflammation of the lining of the renal pelvis. Renal cell carcinoma is adult cancer of the kidney, 2% of all adult cancers. Renal failure, think about what can cause renal failure. Renal hypertension, what is renal hypertension from really regular hypertension? You can get a Wilms tumor, that's a malignant tumor of the kidney occurring in childhood. Here's renal cell carcinoma. Urinary bladder, you can get bladder cancer. Some other associated condition, you can get diabetes insipidus and diabetes mellitus. So diabetes insipidus, you probably don't hear about too much, but the antidiuretic hormone is not secreted adequately or the kidney is resistant to this effect. And then diabetes mellitus is insulin is not secreted adequately or not used properly in the body. So you've heard about this, but diabetes insipidus is the antidiuretic hormone is not secreted adequately. A term that means frequent voluntary urination at night is B, nocturia. Some more lab tests that you can do. You can do a BUN, blood, urea, nitrogen. You can do a creatine clearance test. You can also do CT, urography, kidneys, ureters, and bladders, renal angiography, retrograde pyelogram, voiding cystourethrogram. Okay, these are all things that we can do. Again, medical terminology, I just need you to know what these are. You don't need to know how they work. Okay. CT, computed tomography. So if you look at this, you can see the little cyst right here on the kidney. Voiding cystourethrogram. VSUG, showing a normal female urethra. The bladder is filled with contrast material followed by X-ray imaging. Clinical procedures, you can do an ultrasound examination, ultrasonography, imaging urinary tract structures using high-frequency sound waves. radioactive studies, radioisotope scan, image of kidney after injecting a radioisotope into the bloodstream. You know, MRI, magnetic resonance imaging, a changing magnetic field produces the images of an organ and surrounding structures in three planes of the body. Now here's some other clinical procedures. You can get a cystoscopy, dialysis, lithotripsy, renal angioplasty, renal biopsy, renal transplantation, urinary catheterization. So these are all things that you can definitely do. So cystoscopy would be a direct visual examination of urinary bladder with the endoscope. That doesn't look pleasant. That could be painful, right? And here's the cystoscope, light cord. You put that in there. And hemodialysis, you've heard of dialysis. Continuous ambulatory peritoneal dialysis. Okay. Now here's some abbreviations that you might see in the medical charts. ADH, AKI, ARF, BILI, BUN, CAP, CATH, CCPD, CKD. So ADH is antidiuretic hormone. AKI is acute renal injury. ARF is acute renal failure. BILI would be bilirubin. BUN is blood urea nitrogen. CAPD is continuous ambulatory peritoneal dialysis. CATH is catheter. CCPD, continuous cycling peritoneal dialysis. CKD, chronic kidney disease. CL, CRCL, CRF, CNS, cysto, EG, FR, ESRD, ESWL, HCO3, HD, and IC. You're like, God, that's a lot of stuff. But yeah, you might see those abbreviations in the medical charts. So CL means chloride, a kidney excretion. CRCL is creatinine clearance. CRF is chronic renal failure. CNS is culture and sensitivity testing. Cysto is cystoscopic examination. EGFR, estimated glomerular filtration rate. ESRD, end-stage renal disease, not good. ESWL, extracorporeal shockwave lithotripsy. HCO3, bicarbonate, electrolyte conserved by the kidney. HD is hemodialysis. IC is interstitial cystitis, which is chronic inflammation of the bladder wall. IVP, potassium, KUB, Na sodium, PD, pH, PKD, SPGR, UA, UTI, and VSUG. IVP is intravenous pyelogram. K plus is potassium, which is electrolyte. KUB is kidney, ureter, and bladder. Na plus is sodium, which is electrolyte. PD is peritoneal dialysis. pH is potential hydrogen, degree of acidity or alkalinity. PKD is phenylketonuria. SPGR is specific gravity. UA is urinalysis. UTI is urinary tract infection. And VSUG is avoiding cystourethrogram. So here's some sample quiz questions. The abbreviation RP is associated with which of the following? And that would be contrasted, injected into the urinary bladder and ureters, and x-rays are taken of the urinary tract. Fluid is injected into the peritoneal cavity and then drained out. So A would be continuous ambulatory peritoneal dialysis. C is nitrogenous waste removed from the patient's blood. That's hemodialysis. And an electrolyte is secreted by renal tubules. That could be potassium. The combining form DIPS means thirst, C. Which combining form means pus, and that would be D, pie. And the combining form ISCH, O means, which one? B, to hold back, or back. All right, very good. Again, you don't need to know how kidneys work. You don't need to know how the urinary system works. But you do need to be familiar with all these words and some of these abbreviations. If you're having trouble pronouncing them, you can always go online and have Google type in the word and Google can pronounce it and say, okay, where's the emphasis? The rule of thumb is it's usually not in the beginning or the end. It's usually right in the middle somewhere, second to last syllabus or third to last syllabus. And that's usually a good rule of thumb.